Welcome to EPG Pathshala. In this module, we are going to discuss about intonational phonology. In the first, we are going to discuss what intonational phonology is. Then we want to move on towards the various approaches to the study of intonational phonology. We are going to talk about the British School of Thought, the American School of Thought, and then finally talk about the AM model, which is the autosegmental and metrical model. We are also going to discuss certain examples from Indic languages like Hindi and Bengali. We are going to talk about the intonational phrases, the intermediate phrases, and one of the recent prosodic template, which is the tones and break indices. So let us now begin with the subject in detail. What is intonation? The term intonation refers to the variations in speech melody that speakers or listeners code, decode in order to interpret the syntactic structure of a sentence and its grammatical and pragmatic meanings. So basically, intonation depends upon two prosodic structures, which is the metrical positions of prominence and secondly, the edges of prosodic categories. Intonation is a unique phonological phenomena essentially because it is meaningful in itself. Now, why do we call intonation as meaningful? Because when there is a rise, it's more or less an interrogative sentence. When there is a fall, it becomes a declarative sentence. Let's, for example, in English, when we say John went, that becomes a question. But if I say John went, that becomes a declarative sentence. So now intonation is bringing about difference in meaning in both the utterances. Now from intonation, we also get to know many other pragmatic functions like the attitude of the speaker and the emotions of the speaker while he utters an utterance. Now moving on to the approaches to the study of intonation, some of the following are the prominent approaches that we are going to discuss, which is the British School approach. Then there is the American structuralist approach. We have Pierre Humbert's model, the tone and break indices, and the autosegmental metrical model and the OT model by Gus and Hovel. So the British School model, now the British School of Thought, they laid emphasis more on the tonal structure of a tone unit. Now what this tone unit consists of is a prehead, a head, a nucleus and the tail. This approach was widely used in the teachings of English language. Then comes the American structuralist approach. Now this was a period before generative grammar came into play. So Pike was the main leader of this approach. Pike produced the four-level model of an intonational unit. Now, four-level model, why does he call it the four-level model? Pike took the pitch level as the basic unit of intonation. He considered the pitch level as the basic unit of intonation. He categorized the pitch level into four units. The number one, which was extra high, number two, which was high, number three, mid, number four is low. Now these are the pitch levels. Now if you have to describe a degree of rise or fall given in a language, now we can do by juxtaposing these numbers. Like if I say there is a steep fall, I can say it's one four, like from extra high to low. If I say it's a gradual fall, I may say it's three four, which is from mid to low. So we can describe many degrees of sounds or pitch levels by juxtaposing these numbers. This model was also used by Chomsky and Halley in SPE. Now within the American structuralist model, we also have Bollinger. Now Bollinger said that it is not the pitch but the pitch configuration that is more important to understand intonation. Moving on, we'll discuss now the autosegmental metrical model or the AM model. Now this was one of the dominant model. This was the term autosegmental metrical model was coined by Ladd in 1996. It was based on the fundamental work by Pierre Humbert and it drew on the theoretical foundations of autosegmental phonology by Goldsmith. So what Pierre Humbert proposed was that the pitch levels should be represented as autosegments for intonational analysis. The way we have tones represented for lexical words in autosegmental phonology, in the same manner we are also going to represent pitch levels for intonational analysis as autosegments. Now he said the tones are of three types. What are the three types? It was pitch accent, the phrasal tone, and the boundary tone. Now, the pitch accent tone, we represent it by putting a asterisk after that. The phrasal tone is without an asterisk, and the boundary tone is followed by a percentage mark afterwards. And the levels of pitch have been reduced to two levels, which is low and high. As we discussed earlier in the American structuralist model, Pike had introduced four levels of pitch, whereas in the AM model, they reduced it to two. Now, we preferred this because it gives us a more constrained theory of levels and allowed for a limited set of contrasts in phonological tone, as not all of them could be claimed to be phonologically relevant. Like the one we said that there were so many degrees of fall, like a steep fall, a gradual fall, a normal fall. So many degrees of fall may not be phonologically relevant, although they could be phonetically. So by decreasing it to two, it was more convenient. The AM model of intonation makes the following claim central to the theory, which is: the stonal structure is assumed to be well-defined points in the segmental string, and tonal contours are transitions from one point to another. The second one was, pitch accents are distinct from boundary tones. The distinction lies in the pitch accents being aligned to stressed syllables and boundary tones to the edges of prosodic domains. Now, the stressed syllable had pitch accents, but the final word of an utterance or a sentence carried the boundary tone. So the domains of the both the tones were different. And pitch accent consists of one or a combination of more than one high and low tones subject to OCP. Now, what OCP says is, it's basically the obligatory contour principle. It says that two same tones cannot be adjacent to each other. There has to be a clash. So they cannot be adjacent. Two identical tones cannot be adjacent to each other. Moving on, now we shall discuss about the intermediate phrase. Beckman and Pierre Humbert showed the need for the theory to incorporate an additional intonational unit, which they called as the intermediate phrase. This was basically based on work on Korean and Swedish, which have accentual phrase AP forming directly from the syllables. Now, these accentual phrases or APs were grouped together to form IPs. For example, in Bengali, we'll take a phrase from Bengali which is accentual phrase. It says something like Shamoli amar bari esechilo. Now, as you can see, Shamoli amar bari esechilo. Now, amar bari contains the pitch accents. Basically, bari has the pitch accents, and shamoli, the initial syllable, has the pitch accent. So the accentual phrase in Hindi, in the next slide you can see, it is basically a LH going on there. Now, the initial, the pitch accent is L, and H is basically the phrasal tone, which is the phrasal tone, and lastly we have L percentage, which is the boundary tone. So what we can see, there are three APs, now accentual phrases with LH, LH, LH and one boundary tone. Now, accentual tone basically stands for AP, and the basic intonational unit in an accentual phrase is the accentual tone. Now, let us take the example of Hindi, which has, the example is Grahak ne dawai ko kharida. Now, in Grahak ne dawai ko kharida, we have Grahak, which has the L tone, which is the lowest tone, that is the pitch accent, followed by the H tone, which is the phrasal tone, the phrase tone. Then dawai ko, in dawai ko, dawai has the pitch accent L tone, and ko has the phrasal tone, H tone. And then kharida, in kharida again we have the same HL pattern going on there. So basically, in Hindi, there are now, in this example, there are three APs with tones LH, 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 and there is one boundary tone. So now the type of tone in Hindi and Bengali are most in other Indic languages is like LH, LH, LH and followed by a boundary tone. Now, the boundary tone need not be just a L tone. It can also be an H tone depending upon the type of utterance. If an utterance is an interrogation or some other kind, then there is the boundary tone is a H tone, whereas if it is a declarative sentence, probably the boundary tone would be a L tone. Now, what Sanger Manel said that to propose the same accentual patterns at the IP or the intonational phrase and AP, which is the accentual phrase levels, they however argued that there has to be another optional level of IP, which is the intermediate phrase between IP and AP. So now moving forward to the intonational phrase. An intonational phrase is defined as a prosodic unit delimited phonologically by some sort of intonational feature such as a boundary tone. Now there are other intonational features that may mark an IP are the following. Not only a tone and then boundary tone, but there are also other cues that can talk about an intonational phrase, such as the first and foremost, as we have learned, it's the boundary tone. The second can be a gradual declination. Third is a lengthening, and fourth is final breathiness. We want to see examples of the four types. Boundary tone we have already discussed. Moving forward to gradual declination. Now in gradual declination, it's very commonly found that tones gradually decline in height towards the end of the intonational phrase. As you can see the example there given, the tone, high tone is decreasing in height towards the end. Although the tone is the same, but the amplitude is going on decreasing towards the end of the utterance. Then we have lengthening of the final phrase. Now this is also found in most languages that the final accentual phrase or the intonational phrase or the PP is lengthened towards the end. In the example you can see that do you have two cows, in the end the final phrase is getting lengthened. Now comes breathiness. Breathiness, it's mostly found along with lengthening. That you find that in most of African languages, when there is lax prosody, that you find that there is breathiness also. So the word bina, which means ears, and when that similar word is used as an utterance all alone, it becomes lengthened, and also you can find breathiness in it, as you can see from the Pratt image. Now we want to talk about the tones and break indices. So in tones and break indices, the AM model of intonation has been used to propose a system for prosodic transcription known as tones and break indices. So it is basically a system of prosodic transcription, which is known as the tones and break indices, or TOBI we call it. Now if there are many different types of transcription systems, such as the MAE TOBI, which is the mainstream American English tones and break indices. You also have BTOBI, which is the Bengali tones and break indices, or you have the German tones and break indices. Different languages have their own system of prosodic transcription, which we call as tones and break indices. Now Gassenhoven in 2011 proposed the pitch accents and boundary tones for TOBI, which is the Dutch TOBI. Now first he produced that there are the initial boundary tones, which are L, H, and there is a falling tone HL, and then he talked about the final boundary tones, which are L and H optional, and then he talked about pitch accents such as H, L and HL, LH and so many different kinds. As an attempt at bringing the tonal contours close to phonetic realization, it is common practice to propose modified contours, including differences in duration and pitch levels. Thus, for the tonal contours of Dutch in the DTOBI, Gassenhoven also proposes the following modified tones. Now, after analyzing it, Gassenhoven then proposed the modified tones of Dutch, depending upon the pitch levels. Now, he has put an exclamation marks because there is some kind of downward drift in the high tone, which is not that high. So he has given five tones, which is the down drift of H, and then there is HL tone, then there is low and a falling tone HL, you can find, and then there is a low tone and a mid tone H, the exclamation H L, and then there is H plus L. Now what is plus L is basically it's a steep fall and not a gradual fall. If I just write HL, it's probably a gradual fall. Now if I write plus L, H plus L, then it implies a steep fall or a downstep fall. So in this module, we discussed about the fundamental aspects of intonational phonology. We also discussed about various theoretical models for the study of intonation. We talked about the British school, the American structuralism model, how Chomsky and Halley used it in SPE. Then we moved on to talk about the autosegmental and metrical model, which is currently in use. We also talked about the intonation in various languages such as Bengali and Hindi, and also talked more or less about the need for an intermediate phrase, and also about intonational phrases, which is categorized just not by a boundary tone but also by different characteristics such as breathiness or lengthening or gradual declination, etc. Finally, we talked about the prosodic template, which is widely used nowadays for accounting for intonation in various world languages, which was the tones and break indices. Thank you.